morning, everybody. We are on the road heading north. Pretty views out the window. And today's last day in Arizona. The last day. So excited about the changes. Want to make one quick note that a few days ago I talked about the leveling jacks on the back, and I'm new to leveling jacks. I may have been wrong. I don't think you want the rear off the ground or the front off the ground, but you especially don't want the rear off the ground because that's where your emergency brake is. So I learned stuff from you guys when you let me know. Some of you guys are a lot more experienced than I am, so disregard that part. I will probably edit that out of my video for the future. But yeah, try to keep all rubber on the ground, especially the rear tires. But for right now, we're heading north through the desert. Getting gas here before gas prices go way up. I could not bring the RV over to the RV fuel area because the pickup cars took up all those spots instead. So, whatever. Gas though, I talked about having to pull all the way forward like this because my gas tank is at the rear of the RV. So, but it works okay. As far as gas mileage, I had a lot of viewers say, you know, kiss your gas mileage goodbye now that you got a Class A, Eric. Lots of people. Well, you have to have a context for that, right? So Yoda's 7.8 liter, 8 cylinder, got between 6 and 7 miles per gallon. Miranda, on the first two fill-ups, an 8.8 and an 8.4. Better than Yoda. So it's all about context. I mean, if you're coming from a Geo Metro, yeah, Miranda gets bad gas mileage, but we are pleasantly surprised to actually get better gas mileage in this huge Class A, than we did with Yoda. I'll take 8 or 9 miles per gallon any day. And that was with running the generator. Now that we're not running the generator for, you know, charging the system, we might get closer to 9 or 10. We'll see. Okay, how the heck did I miss this spot on Route 66 a few years ago? Area 66? By the way, we're in Yucca, Arizona, and I believe, yeah, this is a yucca tree with very strange plants. I don't know if those are edible, but a very strange tree, right? It looks like, it looks newer, right? It doesn't look like it's been here very long. Jerky, soda, snacks, beer. But it is definitely closed up, so if it's new, it did not last very long. Any alien creatures in there? No, that's kind of cool. I wonder what happened to this place. Huh. Yeah, see, this is their office. Let's see here. Oh, okay. They are only open Saturday and Sunday here. That makes sense. So a little pit stop, and you know, when we were driving on Route 66, we got to a point where it was like, rest area 50 miles, rest area 10 miles, rest area 2 miles, and then rest area closed. I think Arizona has more closed rest areas than any other state in the country, and this place could do well with all those closed rest areas if they were open. I don't think this is closed, so let's go check it out. You don't got to pay a lot, Eric, you just got to pay attention. This gate blended in with the stairs. It is definitely locked. So, no idea what's up there. Maybe a little restaurant or something, but they don't want any business on the weekdays. Weird. So we couldn't get, there was no access back to 40 from Route 66, so we were kind of forced to stay on Route 66 a little longer, and it is very weird. Very little abandoned place here. Watch out for glass. Ooh, not everybody's into these abandoned places, but I find them kind of fascinating. Because there's so much history. I mean, look, the basketball hoop they put up in here and front end of a Cadillac here. This had to have been an old auto wrecking junkyard place abandoned because they got a semi truck suspended up on a big pole up there, kind of to greet everyone on Route 66, hey, come get an oil change, come get your semi-truck tires. Yeah, that's what this was. Not too many people would want to venture in. Oh my. We're not going in there. Nope, getting back on the road. Gosh, I love Route 66. Welcome to Santa Claus, Arizona. And some places have not aged well, let's be honest. But if you can imagine, this area used to be home to a little theme park that just recently closed. I mean, I think 1995 is when it closed, and it is unrecognizable anymore. I'll flash some pictures up on your screen of what Santa Claus Town used to look like back in its heyday. But now it's just covered in graffiti. If it said private property somewhere, I would always obey those. But if it doesn't, then I guess it's just for us to look at, right? You know, this may have been where the elves slept. I think so. Whoa. There's what's left of the welcome sign. I think it said, "This is it, Santa's land." Can we peek in this window and not have anything jump out at us? Oh man, so sad. Okay, this one I'm not stepping into either because the floor is all tore up in spots. In fact, it's missing most of the floor. Don't think we're missing anything though. How did this place make any money? Weird. What's in here? Oh, wow. Just think of how many rattlesnakes are living underneath these boards. No thanks. A piece of history lost, but not forgotten. Mm-hmm. All right, it said when we pulled in that this is the last stop in Arizona before a new state, so hopefully they got some food here. Now the windshield, hey, I try to keep it clean, guys, but it's like we got mustard stains all over. All around where I'm trying to have the camera at. Yeah, just full of mustard stains. Lovely. Just want you to know, I do try, but it's hard to keep up, and I can't do it but more than once a day right now. For what? Okay, we'll see in a little bit. I'll crack some windows, okay? All right, man. Interesting little spot full of everything. It says live fire. There's a gun range over here, as evidence from Mr. Metal Machine Gun Man here. Yeah, looking good, dude. Why no smile? Oh, okay. They got it all. Check it out. A little Rambo mural there. That is awesome. What are these cutouts? Oh, you can be alien men too. Okay, cool. But there we go. Last stop. Gas, lotto, machine guns, Marilyn Monroe, and of course, aliens. Of course, guys. Look at all the awesome artwork here. Oh, Harry. Wow. And Blues Brothers there with
"I'll be back."
And helicopter tours, of course. And, you know, if you're looking for a tire upgrade, this bad boy right here might get the job done. What is this? Sin City Hustler. That's a big boy there. I'll take up a couple lanes. All right, let's go see about grub. Now, I'm off the cheeseburgers. It's been a little while, but I'm definitely off the cheeseburgers and looking for something else.
World famous though? I don't know.
Coke, let's go. Right, it's world famous. It's the way she goes, just the way she goes. Those are all quotes from Trailer Park Boys, just in case you're wondering. Oh, it's like Inception. That was a good burger. Now we have quite a few magnets to choose from. They have an entire wall of magnets. Oh boy.
Look at all these quirky magnets. Oh man.
Arizona, it's a dry heat.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, it's simple and small, but it does say last stop, so it'll signify this place. And it's a small form factor. I kind of like it.
Yep, that's going to be the one.
All right, last stop in Arizona, but not really the last stop for us. It's the last approved spot, but we're gonna boondock one more time on some BLM land here on the Arizona side for tonight, which means we have to put on a few more miles before we get parked. And I'll show you where we head up. We're heading for Kingman Wash. right, I think this'll work. This will work. Now, there is another Kingman wash up on the other side of the highway, but it's going to take 15, 16 minutes to get up 3 miles, and this is right off the highway. It'll work great for one night, so we'll get comfortable here. Actually, you know what? I've never shown you guys how easy it is to get level with this RV. You put the e-brake on, you turn it on, and you hit auto. It does the fronts first, then it does the backs, gets us nose to heel level, and then it works on our side to side. And although you can't see it because of the sun, once this is green in there, we are level. Can turn it off, turn the engine off. But as you can see, we're not quite comfortable yet, so I'm gonna push button both of our slides out. Slide one out. Slide two out. Easy as pie, like a transformer everywhere we go. Oh yeah, oh boy, it is bright and sunny. Woo! But, might be some little trails up through there, and just 3 miles north of here is the Hoover Dam. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's bright. It's bright. Woo! Overhead fan going, might as well. The batteries are never going to leave 100%. Look at this view. I mean, if it weren't for all the mustard looking butterfly things all over the windshield, no, it's pretty. I kind of don't even want to put the blinds out for this view tonight. Let's go outside. Let's go around the bend and see what we can find out. I'll be back, honey. Enjoy. Let's go see what's going on the other side of the RV here. Because even with the highway right there, this is one of the more remote places that you can be at with apparently nobody else who wants to camp in this area. And you know what? Right after walking over all those hot rocks, I just realized that's a breeding ground for scorpions. Oh, wow. Oh, boy. Oh, boy, we've come to a cliff. I'm going to leave you with a cliffhanger, guys. That's a long way down. Little wash down there, or it may have been a river of some sort. Oh boy. It's pretty though. Pretty view. May even bring our chairs out here tonight, sit here with our backs to the freeway, and see if we can get a nice sunset happening over there by Hoover Dam. It's pretty. All right, I'll cut back in here later this evening, guys. Actually, I have decided to cut this video off a little early this afternoon so that I can get to editing and spend some more time with Angela tonight. So, I'm not going to give you any evening shots, but I had a lot of fun today. I almost feel like this was back to, like, Route 66, my old quirky travels. And it was fun sharing that with Angela throughout the day, so, and, you know, going to restaurants and not eating alone. So, no, actually, this worked out really well, guys. So, anyway. We'll be back from a new state in our next video. You guys take care, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye. Let's play a game, guys. Tip over the rock and find the scorpions. Nothing? Okay. This one's got one. Nothing? What the heck? Okay, this one's definitely got one. Here we go, guys. Ready? Eric, that was mean. That was mean, Eric.